Yo, what's up, guys? In today's video, I'm going to be showing you another Mayhem 4 Zane boss killing build for Borderlands 3. I've been playing with this build all day today, and it absolutely melts. A lot of you saw the Grave Ward build we posted yesterday, so today, instead, we're going to be mixing things up. Now, before we get into it, don't forget to like this video, subscribe to the channel for more Borderlands 3, Mayhem 4, Zane builds. Don't forget to join the Zane Nation Discord. Link will be in a pinned comment down below. I had a couple people complain in the comment section that the build yesterday could only kill Grave Ward, so today I'm going to be killing Captain Trunt. Now, I do want to say your build should change depending what boss you're farming. You can't always hit Grave Ward with the same attacks you hit Trunt with, and vice versa. What these videos are really supposed to highlight is the damage scaling you can get with Zane's speed now. With the recent patch, they buffed the scaling to violent momentum, so the faster you're moving, the more damage you put out. Yesterday's video, we were jumping off the map to get a max speed damage bonus, but today we're doing something a bit different. So let's get into it. The gun we're using this time is probably my new favorite gun. I used it during the Malawan takedown. That's the protuberance. I have a shock variant, and usually I like to find one anointed with the next two magazines give 50% bonus damage to a different element. It doesn't really matter which one. The gun hits for an insane amount of damage either way. I'm going to put on the screen a screen capture. I was able to hit over 2 million damage with one shot. This thing melts. All the clips you're seeing in the background is multiple different kills, me doing it consistently. Besides that, I'm using my anti-freeze class mod. This adds 40% damage while sliding. And then for the shield, we're using a rerouter. Now, you might have noticed we're not using a transformer, so that means you can't actually kill yourself in this build on accident. I think I put a clip near the beginning of this video that shows me killing myself, so just get used to not trying to shoot yourself and you'll be fine. Now for the grenade, we're using a piss grenade. You know, Zane doesn't throw grenades himself, but we got some cool tricks on how we're going to get this out there. And finally, this is probably the most important piece of gear in this whole loadout, a Snowdrift splatter gun. This thing not only boosts our speed by 100%, but the splatter gun is going to give us 50% shotgun damage while we're sliding. This is an insane piece of gear for this build. It's probably giving us more damage than anything else, even the rerouter. Now, what's really cool about all this stuff is you saw some anointments on some of my gear, but if you pay attention in some of these clips, usually Trunt is dead or we've already done most of the damage before any of our action skills end, and what that means is most of these clips don't require anointed items. Otherwise, though, it's obviously not a bad thing to get anointments. It's just going to boost your damage. But I think it's really cool that a lot of these clips were made without any of them activated. Now, I gotta say real quick, the Zane buffs last week definitely did some weird things with violent momentum. I might make a whole video about it, but we've been testing and getting some different results between the different people testing. Just know that if you want to get max damage out of Zane right now, I think it's in the movement speed. You're going to want to move as fast as possible. So just like Amara has an elemental projector, I think the Snowdrift is Zane's artifact of choice right now. On to the skills. I'm just going to put them up on the screen for a moment and talk about them. The most important skills are violent momentum, violent speed, cold bore, playing dirty, and all the other damage skills in the other trees, synchronicity, Donnybrook, confident competence. We're basically taking as much damage as we can get out of all of his skills because we're just trying to like burst out as much damage as we can. We don't care about survivability so much. All of that gets doubled with playing dirty. I don't know if you guys know this, but cold boar actually scales 30% to all of your overall damage. And then we're going to double all of that once again with the rerouter. The other cool thing is I put 1 point into fractal frags. If you notice in all these clips, On my way, I put my clone right in Tron's face. Basically, the clone is going to piss all over him. And that's another 20% that once again scales with all of our damage. That's how I hit over 2 million in the picture I showed you guys earlier. I'm sure I'm hitting that in most of these slide shots, as in most of these clips, his whole entire shield is gone in one hit. And I'm pretty sure Captain Trant has a really big shield. But yeah, we're basically just using the most speed possible to get the most scaling out of Violent Momentum possible. We're doubling it all twice between Playing Dirty and the Rerouter. We're using Cold Bore and the Piss Grenades, which scale your total damage. We're really just combining a lot of stuff together to get some insanely consistent kills like this. Now, I do want to bring back up, like I said earlier, I mentioned how I farmed Grave Ward yesterday. I farmed Captain Trant today. Depending what boss you're farming, obviously you'll probably end up needing some different types of gear, some different weapons. You know, this Captain Trant is resistant against fire, but General Trant is resistant against shock. So you might want to use a different element protuberance against General Trant. Just stuff like that. But really what I want to highlight in these videos is the scaling of the damage you can get. And that's pretty much it. I don't know when I'm going to do it, but I think we definitely need some speed Zane kills out on YouTube. It's still going to be really challenging, but the protuberance is an amazing weapon. I love it. If you don't have your hands on one, go ahead and get one. But that's probably about it for today's video, guys. I hope I showed you some insane stuff, stacking all these skills together, the insane damage that Violent Momentum can scale to. As always, if you have any questions, please comment down below. I love helping you guys out, answering your questions. I reply to nearly every comment I can get to. There's a lot of comments sometimes. But with all that being said, don't forget to like the video, subscribe to the channel for more Borderlands 3 Mayhem 4 Zane builds, and join the Zane Nation Discord, guys. You can talk to me more there, too. But have a great day, guys. I'm out.